Leg 7 of the 2017-18 Volvo Ocean Race produced the most difficult sailing that the race has seen in many years, certainly the most grueling in this edition to date. The relentless conditions tested boats and crew. Relentless southern ocean storms producing massive seas made daily life above and below deck challenging.
Right on the limit. But yeah, it's pretty rough.
Leg 7 marked the halfway point of the race and the final leg through the southern ocean. And after 7,600 miles and 16 days of intense racing, a new overall race leader emerged.
Let's get to it, enjoy. Full speed. Let's go.
After defending the lead for more than a week, Bauer Becking's Team Brunel took a hard-fought Leg 7 victory by just 15 minutes from Dongfeng Race Team. It was their first leg win of the 2017-18 Volvo Ocean Race, and the team scored maximum points, including bonus points for leading around Cape Horn and for the leg win. The result puts Becking and Brunel back in the game, vaulting them from 6th to 3rd in the standings, and a much-needed confidence boost following a slow start to their campaign.
It's bloody hard, so it was actually good that we pulled this one off in a lot of ways, because I think from the beginning on till the end, you've been sailing a very solid leg. And of course, then you can win the leg as well. That's a nice icing on the cake.
Dongfeng Race Team's second was their fifth podium finish of the race, and capitalizing on Spanish rival Matt Frey's battles with a damaged mast track and a mainsail at Cape Horn, the Chinese flag Dongfeng Race Team takes over as race leaders.
A very tough leg, probably one of the toughest legs of the Volvo Ocean Race. But at the end, for us, very positive. The leader, Matt Frey, will probably finish 4 or 5, and we finish second. That means we take the lead. So very proud of the team, what we have done, because it was really tough, and we proved that we don't form a team, a strong team. We'll be ready for the next one, which is one of our favorite legs, going to Newport, that we won last time.
Rounding off the podium was Team AkzoNobel, 2 days behind the leading duo. Di Cafari's Turn the Tide on Plastic took their best result of the race, with a well-earned fourth place on the hardest leg of the race to date.
It feels like we've won the leg, and I can't believe it. At 2 o'clock in the morning, there's this many people out to welcome us in. But definitely, and we're getting better and better. So the fact that we did a really good job in a light wind leg, and now we've done it in a big heavy wind leg. We were crossing jibes with Matt Frey and Dongfeng in the Southern Ocean, and that really gave us a lot of confidence. But the memory of Auckland is still very, very raw, because we were still working out how fast Matt Frey had to go to overtake us, even though we'd built a 300-mile buffer, we were not convinced it was enough. So we're delighted to be in safe and sound, and they're still out there.
Finishing in unfamiliar territory, a full 5 days behind the leaders was Matt Frey, who had to settle for fifth place. Losing time at Cape Horn when they elected to suspend racing to carry out repairs. But the team is still very much in the fight, just a single point now separating them from the new overall race leaders, Dongfeng Race Team.
We always known that it's very hard to keep in the lead the whole way, and you know, we've been here before. And I think we have to be happy enough that with all the problems this leg and the 5 points we had in the pocket before, we are still right there in the race with 1 point behind, which is nothing, and we won't do any changes and just need to rest and keep sailing as we are.
Vestas 11th Hour Racing also experienced their own difficulties. After running second for much of the leg, the American-Danish flag team dismasted just south of the Falkland Islands. Retiring from the leg to regroup at the Falklands, the Vestas 11th Hour Racing crew built a jury rig to help them get back to Itajaí in time to fit a new mast ahead of the Leg 8 restart to Newport.
Our best option now is to get directly to Itajaí from here, so the plan is to build a jury rig after we were dismasted. We've managed to find an aluminium pole.
We're going to try and make our storm jib fit from the front. We've asked Skip Novak if we can have a look at his container load of sails he's got for a couple of boats here, the Pelagic.
Doing a couple touches to these old sails we found, and then we should be able to get ready to. Once the breeze stops, it's like 50 knots out there right now. Once the breeze dies down, we should be able to step the rig and get it all ready to leave. Get out of here, get on our way to Itajaí.
Also on delivery to Itajaí is the Song Hong Kai Scallywag boat. Following the tragic loss of crewman John Fisher, the team made landfall in Chile, where a delivery team stepped aboard. The boat is now en route to Itajaí with hopes of making the start of the upcoming leg. 11,000 miles remain in the 2017-18 Volvo Ocean Race. Past halfway, the teams are now focusing on the race home towards Europe. But first, the Itajaí import race, followed by Leg 8, which takes the fleet north towards the world-famous sailing mecca of Newport, Rhode Island, starting April 22nd.